Hello everybody, Andy from Andy's Travel Blog here with a special sneak preview of the brand new Sony a7 III. Okay, this is technically the a7 R3 that you hopefully watched my review of. I'll post a link to it. Here's why I'm showing you the a7 R3 when I'm really giving you my first impressions of the a7 III. It's kind of the same camera with the exception that the a7 R3 has 42 megapixels and costs $3,200. The new a7 III looks like this, smells like this, it shoots like this, but it only costs $2,000. Let's talk about specs. You want specs? Okay, here's what we got. The a7 III that Sony just announced today, and it's gonna go on pre-sale or pre-order tomorrow morning, shoots 10 frames per second at full RAW. 10 frames per second, 177 images and a buffer. I think it's JPEG, but who knows. So 10 frames per second. It shoots 4K video at up to 30 frames per second. It shoots slow motion, 120 frames per second at 1080p HD. So for video, it's great because it shoots in like 4K HDR with S-Log 3 and all that stuff. And then for still shots, it's phenomenal as well. It has a 24.2 megapixel sensor. It's a Sony sensor, so you know it's going to have really good dynamic range. They say 15 stops of dynamic range. We'll see. It's probably 14, 14 and a half. It has, this is incredible, 693 autofocus points. That covers 93% of the sensor. And you know what? That's more autofocus points than the Sony a7 R3. What they basically did is they took the exact autofocus system from the Sony a9 and put it on the a7 III. I am absolutely blown away. Realistically, when you look at the segments, okay, so we have the a7 R3. This competes against the Canon 5D Mark IV and the Nikon D850. So in price range, the D850, I believe, is $3,600. The 5D Mark IV and the a7 R3 run about $3,200. Well, the a7 R3, again, this is the model for it. A7 R3 competes against the Canon 6D Mark II, the Nikon D750, which uses a version of the same sensor, and the Fuji XH1, which was just announced. So the XH1 shoots 4K video at a good bit rate, but it's an APS-C camera. It's a crop sensor. The D750 is a great camera, but it doesn't have the video features of this, and it doesn't shoot as fast as this. It doesn't shoot 10 frames per second like the a7 III. The Canon 6D Mark II doesn't shoot as fast as this. Sure, it has 2 more megapixels, but meh, it's kind of a wash. And that only shoots 1080p video because Canon just decided to mail it in on that. So the a7 III is going to be amazing. Now, the reason I'm showing you all this, it shares the same body as the a7 R3 and a lot of the same elements as the a9. So you're going to have this right here, which is a bigger battery. I love this bigger battery on my a7 R3 and the a9 the times I've used it. What else do you get? You also get 2 memory card slots. So all those people saying I'd never use a Sony because it only has 1 memory card slot, now you have the change to Sony. So that's great. You also have a touch screen right here. So you can turn this on, touch where you want it to focus, and it's actually pretty great. I never thought I would use it, but I really am using it. You have a better record button, you have an AF on button for back button autofocus, and you have this little joystick. Everybody was complaining about Sony not having a joystick, now you have one. So you put all that together, and it's $2,000. It's $2,000 for the body only, and then I think it's $2,199 or $2,200 to include the 28-70 kit lens, which, to be honest, it's not a bad kit lens. It's stabilized and everything. So yeah, it includes the 5-axis image stabilization and all that. I cannot believe that Sony put all that, and they kind of insulted themselves. They said this was the basic model. There's nothing basic about it. Honestly, this is like class-leading stuff. It honestly competes almost with a 5D Mark IV, with the exception of the 4D autofocus or whatever they're calling it, dual phase, I mean, whatever it's called. So I am blown away, and like I cooked dinner and it's actually getting cold because I needed to react to this and give you my first impressions of it. So I'm absolutely blown away. Now, that said, am I gonna get one? Honestly, I might. So I have this a7R III. I'm shooting this with the a7R II, and I'm selling my a6500. But this a7 III is a pretty compelling package, I think, especially at that price point. So for all you Canon and Nikon shooters out there, Sony basically destroyed the announcement of the Canon EOS M50, the mirrorless camera that shoots 4K, like super cropped in. Sony's gonna shoot that at full frame. It actually shoots in 6K and downsamples to 4K, so you get even better footage. So I'm absolutely blown away. I hope you can realize that excitement. If you wanna pre-order the a7 III, as soon as the pre-order links are available, I'll have it down below. I'm absolutely blown away. I hope you enjoyed my first impressions. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. Like, comment, and subscribe, all that nonsense. Mash whatever it is that you're supposed to mash. And yeah, I will talk to you next time. This has been a sneak peek of the kind of a7 III from Sony. This is Andy Luton from Andy's Travel Blog. We will see you next time.